what I wish I could do, what you keep telling me to do. Watch this. Buck, come. Buck, come. Buck, 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 buck. You see what happened when I called Buck? You see what happened when I called Buck? Oh, you see what, Greg? You see what that devil did when I called the name? When I said I got somebody greater is he.
Send me in.
So what you do every time Buck comes, come on, Buck.
Yeah.
Listen, there's a future that God knows. future that God has for you, you are the perfect fit for it because he knew you before he knit you together in your mother's womb. That's how long God has known you, and that is the you God is loyal to. And he will do what it takes to bring you into the life that he's called you to live, not only for you, but for his glory and for others. God's not through with you. You don't get to stay down there talking about, if it were that easy, I would have done it by now. No, you just haven't walked in what you were taught long enough yet to see the fruit of your faith. And you never will if you keep fighting your future because you are in love with your familiar. Don't fight your future. When God sends you correction, get quicker to accept it. Don't be so defensive to the point that you stay dysfunctional because you are so defensive, because you get humiliated when somebody sees something. So instead of humbling yourself and saying, all right, I thought about that for about the last three days, and I think I do need to go and apologize, you just do you and go off and don't speak for 8 months and stay down. You know, I know that we all struggle with different forms of bondage and captivity. I know that. I am not a judgmental dude. Not at all. I would be if the Lord had done a better job getting me past the point where I'm at right now. But he works on me slow, so I won't get all uppity and think I'm there. So he has left. Remember when they used to say in sports that somebody would have a loser's limp? It means you pretend to be hurt so that you have an excuse for losing. In the kingdom of God, he gives you a winner's limp. Like Jacob, who wrestled with his angel, won, and limped away. To remind him, for the rest of his life, that he needs God. And tricks are for kids. And deceitful desires have to go in this season so that I can step into what I was designed by God to be and accomplish what I was called by God to accomplish. For he knows the plans he has for me. And I know the problems I have. And he knows the plans. He knew me before I had the problems, and he knows the plans before I have them. So, remember I said I would give you the teaching and then an illustration from Graham, and you didn't know you were going to get all that action today, I'll tell you right now. But I said I want to give you a picture, and it is indeed a very unusual one. But when the people of God were coming into the promised land, they needed to be taught how to transition. We all do. And when we are not taught what to do with our former way of life, we just repeat what nobody was there to teach us. To admit that you weren't taught, or that you might have been taught wrong, requires humility. So I'm really proud. I shouldn't say I'm proud of Moses, because what does he care if I'm proud of him? But I think I want to be like Moses, who had learned so many lessons in the wilderness from his own mistakes, that when he was getting the generation that went after him ready to follow Joshua into the land God was giving them, which they would subdue and conquer, just town by town, battle by battle, fight by fight, he gave them such specific instructions to not worship the gods of the people all around them. Most of us weren't taught that. We were just handed idols.
Day 11.
They didn't sit as statues in our living room.
Let's keep going.
Idolatry.
It's a day 11.
Of life that was handed down to us in a lot of ways. Not saying your parents were bad. I'm not saying they were bad. And put on the armor of God. Now unto him who is able to do immeasurably more
don't fade from the battle, so you miss the blessing.
I forgot to do one more. How to finish.